Coming to Northeast Wisconsin live from the Civic Media Studios at the City Deck Landing in Green Bay and featuring TV and radio broadcast veteran John Maino, along with the City of Green Bay's longest serving mayor, Jim Schmidt. This is Maino and the Mayor. Here are your hosts, John Maino and Jim Schmidt.
Good
morning. You're going to get a fine again.
Well, no, I was ready. I was just telling him a story.
He's going on and on about this story from yesteryear.
Yeah. Good morning, everybody. Happy Friday to you. Another beautiful morning out there.
Oh, this weekend. You see that? 71.
Beautiful, phenomenal, fantastic. Mm-hmm. This is a great time of year. Fishing season.
Yes. Is the water warm enough now? It's too cold to fish.
Opening season is never too good.
Okay.
You know, depending on what you're going after, but inland fishing, stream fishing, trout, which is what I always used to go after, they're pretty finicky, brook trout, you know, about water temperature, if they're going to be active or not.
Yeah.
So, but with this kind of weather, that'd be great, to be honest with you. I've gotten out trout fishing in the UP, and that opened last weekend, where there'd still be snow on the banks.
Yeah.
Yeah, lots of times that would happen.
Fun.
51 in Green Bay right now, 52 in Appleton, 53 in Oshkosh. Had a great time in Two Rivers last night.
Yeah, how was
that? Great. The Heart-O-Rama.
Yes.
And Todd, you put some pictures up, huh?
Yeah, it's up on Maino and the Mayor Facebook page.
All right. Did it kind of look like I was the odd guy out?
Yeah, just a little.
In the high school yearbook where you have clubs?
Yeah.
Like science club or something?
It took me a bit to find you in that group shot.
Yes.
I'm like, where's Maino? Where's Nope, there's an alien. Nope.
The cone head.
There's a cone head. Yep. Exactly. Princess Leia.
Spock.
Yes. Yep.
Yeah. Princess Leia looked a lot like her, didn't she?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was neat. You know what? It's just local, home ground, community people doing fun theater type things for a phenomenal cause. Really nice crowd there last night at one of my favorite venues. I've been to 8 million different venues, and one of my favorite three is that community center in Two Rivers.
Yeah. It's actually called the community house, but
whatever
it's just,
it is.
No, it's just,
get lost in there. They're going to have a pre-thing meeting, and they're like, I heard somebody say, can somebody go find Maino? And I walk in. I said, I'm sorry, I got lost.
But no, the reason I just want to say it's community house is I think they take care of it like it's their house.
Yeah.
You know that.
How old is it, do you think?
Oh, man, that's,
100 years old, maybe?
Yeah, it's close.
And it is pristine.
It is.
It is such a perfect, wonderful place, the community house in Two Rivers.
Yeah.
And if you need directions, it's right outside of the Schmidt Brothers pavilion.
Did you see that?
Yeah.
It must have.
Of course.
Right across the street.
So. Yeah, and got cool city there with the coffee shop now, man, and everything. That's cool.
That guy's got it going.
I love Two Rivers.
Yeah.
I really do. Yeah. But I had a great time last night. It's such a great thing. It's three nights now. I think tonight is sold out with Charlie Barron's, but I'm not positive. And tomorrow night, Bill Jarts will be helping out with what we do. We donated it's one raffle item, okay? And it's a toilet seat. It's called Best Seat in the House, an especially designed, monogrammed toilet seat. And if anybody uses it, my autograph's on it.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So
I know it's a few people who'd like to use it. Okay, go ahead.
And it went for $2,000.
That's great, because he said that last one went for like $1,400.
Yeah, $2,000.
Good for you, man. That's awesome.
So
did you do the auction?
I helped with it. Yeah. I went out in the crowd and, you know,
sat on
your
lap and all that. Yeah.
Yeah, okay, but the whole theme was the Sputnik landing in Manitowoc.
Oh yeah, which is very, very cool.
Do they really have that in Manitowoc?
Totally, right on 8th Street. And Hugh, remember
the
Hugh Downs?
The actual one or replica?
No, it was the one.
They still have it in Manitowoc.
Well, it fell in. It landed
62.
In Manitowoc.
Yeah. Okay.
Remember Hugh Downs, you guys?
Sure.
Todd does.
Yeah. Hugh Downs, absolutely. Sure.
Came to Manitowoc. This is where it happened. Yeah, Hugh Downs was in Manitowoc. Big deal. My dad was all excited about it.
You've read the story about his son, who then became a reporter for CBS, very, very, very seriously wounded in Vietnam.
Oh.
His dad was covering Vietnam, and his son was in Vietnam. I want to say a Marine.
Wow.
And got really terribly wounded in one of the worst battles of the Vietnam War.
Huh.
Yeah. I read his book.
I bet that was, and maybe his dad helped him. Hugh Downs was quite the guy. And then he really got into that later in life of living forever. Remember that with the stem cells and all that? Anybody follow that? Todd?
I don't remember that.
I don't remember that either, to be
I remember he was a great game show host, and I remember that he was in the news, you know,
with
person.
Barbara Walters, right?
Hugh Downs was a game show host?
He hosted Jeopardy for a while. Sure.
I didn't know that.
He would be good at that, right? Can't you see Hugh Downs doing that? Yeah, he was I think people trusted him.
Yeah.
No, you guys, if you look, because he lived in Arizona, right? In Scottsdale. And I towards, yeah, he really wanted to, and I think he lived a long time. I think he lived to be, I don't know, 90, something, or maybe 100, but
99.
Very
wow. Good.
Yep.
Darn. So what did he do?
What he was just, he would talk about how, just he was, he got into that whole longevity. I just remember seeing a, I don't know, an episode, something he did on that. I was like, well, that's pretty interesting. So I don't, it was, but he died, so it didn't work, but,
wow, I didn't know that.
Well, he still lived to 99. That's I'll tell you what, time.
And he, the guy's pretty healthy too, right? I mean, he
was this thinner guy, I remember.
Right, yeah. That's true. That, so.
But yeah, oh, no, I don't think it was Hugh Downs. I think it was Howard K. Smith. Do you remember Howard K. Smith?
I remember the name.
ABC.
I remember that. So it's his son?
Or was yes.
Okay.
Can you look that up real quick, Todd? Howard yep. K. Smith. And then, Todd, we got to talk about something. You know, when I do the community house, every year we do the big... what's it called? The game show.
Price is Right.
Price is Right.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And it's hugely popular.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. The three of us, for a fundraiser, we need to do a game show.
All right.
We need to do it. Find a venue where we can do it at. You know, one of the bar, big back rooms or something like that. Oh, Jack Smith it was. Jack Smith.
I believe that Jack Smith was the son.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So Jack Smith, during this, his son, future ABC newsman Jack Smith, was serving the U.S. Army 7th Cav Regiment in South Vietnam and fought at the Battle of Aya Drang. The Battle of Aya Drang is what the movie We Were Soldiers Once is based on. There were two Medal of Honor recipients coming out of that battle. It was horrific. It was the first big battle of the Vietnam War, 1965, and the American troops just got ambushed like you can't believe. But the whole movie with Mel Gibson is based on that battle, and he was one of the guys there. Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that wasn't Hugh Downs' son, though.
It was Jack Smith's son.
And who's
Howard K. Smith's
son.
Howard K. Smith.
Yes.
Boy, I know that name.
Well, he was big time.
Yeah,
he was ABC. But you know what? I didn't watch him when I was a kid because we didn't have ABC. We only had CBS.
Okay.
So he would have been opposite of like Walter Cronkite.
Okay, and that's why I didn't watch him.
You know what
him.
I mean? It was kind of like Walter Cronkite and everybody else.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, but okay. I bet if you see a picture of him, I'm going to
you'd recognize him. Absolutely.
I'm going to try and throw it up here for you guys.
Because he did some news specials for a lot of years.
Yeah. I do know the name, but yeah.
Yeah. Howard K. Smith.
Oh, yeah.
He had that real distinctive voice.
Yeah,
he did.
He had the jaw, right?
Right.
Yeah.
The hair.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tried to be a little bit like Walter.
Well, they all did, didn't they?
Why
you?
Not?
Yeah, too.
Absolutely. Exactly. So would I.
Emulate the guy that does it best. No question. But I'm serious about this, guys. Todd, I'm going to leave this to you.
All right.
Which game show, because we're not going to reinvent a game show.
Right.
Which game show would you like to do? The Price is Right is really popular in Manitowoc. Really popular.
Where do you get all the stuff?
Got to get it donated, but then they get publicity.
Like a car?
No, they didn't do anything there. They gave away a motorcycle, like a scooter was the grand prize.
That wouldn't be bad.
That wasn't bad at all.
Okay.
But they would have like, okay, let's bring up Martha. Okay, and Martha comes up and it's like, music. And then they all do their bids, you know.
Let's do it at the Tarleton.
$28.
Let's do it at the Tarleton.
Tarleton would be great.
Because it's small.
And that would be perfect.
If it works, we'll do it. We'll have a game show during the NFL draft, like during the day. People can come. They're like chilling.
Like
we want to get them downtown. We'll use the Meyer Theater. But we'll do, like everybody, right? We'll test our show at the Tarleton. Smaller venue.
Yeah.
If it works.
I love it.
Meyer. And then sometime we'll
for,
do it.
For
we'll
people
it
out there, let us know what you think would be the most fun game show to do. And we'll find a charity we're giving it all to. I would like to give it to my amputee softball people, but whatever charities you think would be best for the community, we'll do. I think we could really pull this off, and I think we'd have a lot of fun with it.
Todd, you know what? And
This is your wheelhouse.
Well, Todd will pick the show. You'll be the host of the show, and then I'll work on getting some items.
I think it's got to be like a big show. You know, like Password's fun, but it's not
that. Yeah, exactly.
We need either like The Price is Right.
Where the crowd gets involved.
Let's make a deal.
Oh, yeah.
That would be fun now. Because then we could get some zonk prizes, too.
I forgot about let's make a deal. Yeah.
But with Let's Make a Deal, I guess that would be easy. We could just get some drape and rod, but we have to have curtains to put stuff behind.
Yeah.
We could do that.
Right.
That'd be easy.
You'd almost have to have that too for The prices, right? To do it right?
Yeah, you do.
Okay, that's not going to be a problem. They got all that stuff over
and
there.
And I get some hotties, let's be honest.
Some Carol Merrill's?
Some Janice Pennington's?
Yeah.
Todd, you work on that.
No, no, John, you're in charge of that.
Guys, I got so much to do.
This is your category.
Why don't you just pile on?
Yeah, John, that's going to take you maybe 10, 15 minutes. So I'm not too worried about you.
Hey, how you doing?
All right, that's going to be fun.
We're doing this.
You guys, we'll announce the event at our anniversary party.
Okay.
On the 26th. We'll announce it, and then we'll do it.
We're doing one, like, let's do fall. One before, yeah, let's do one in the fall.
Fall, and then we'll test it. If it really, really works, we'll say, hey, look, the next draft one happens to be April 27th.
Yeah. Or
during, like, on that Wednesday, during the day, because at night, everybody's going to be at the draft. So something maybe after the show, maybe at 10 o'clock, 10:30, people come down and, you know what I mean?
Something.
Have lunch at the Heights or, there's so many places. Hey, Fresh Kind, did he get back to you? I think he's coming out for our Spotlight of the Week.
Okay, cool. I've not heard from him, but.
Okay, all right. I talked to him last night. He's going to be.
I like that place.
I want to say thanks to Brian at the Heights because I went in for lunch yesterday and he got me a cap because I don't know if you know this, Jim, but Brian gave Maino three caps, one for him, one for you, and one for me.
Oh,
and we didn't see him.
What did you sell them?
No, they're upstairs. I'll go get them.
It's okay. I got mine.
I didn't think you were cap guys.
Look at this.
I didn't think you were cap guys.
It's all right. Good. It's all good.
I actually got one of their pullovers the other day. I wore it last night at that thing. They're cool.
I told Brian to go online to eBay and see if you're trying to sell it. Make a couple of bucks.
Yeah,
no, there's so many good restaurants down here now and that are open for lunch, which is great. And matter of fact, the Daily Buzz is going to start serving lunch again next week, I think, or maybe it's this week. Anyway, there's a lot of places, but it'd be fun to get people down here. That, of course, that's the draft. But,
well, our waterfront place right next door, our waterfront market, is going to be serving food.
Yeah. Yep.
I can't wait for that. I hope they have breakfast sandwiches.
Ooh, that'd be nice.
Yeah.
That'd be good. John, I don't think we need that.
Oh, but, I love breakfast sandwiches. Well, don't you?
Who doesn't? Yes.
Like a hot...
Any time of day.
Any time of day, a breakfast sandwich is delicious. Yeah. I could live on breakfast sandwich. We got a huge show, folks.
Yeah,
Alec Ingold.
You know who we got? Yeah, this is great.
All-pro fullback for the Miami Dolphins. All-state fullback, or quarterback, actually, of Bayport Pirates. All-Big Ten for the Wisconsin Badgers.
And they did a whole NFL thing on him. I mean, this guy's
big
time.
What he's doing off the field is amazing. We got Bell Sports Medicine coming up. Charlie Queen will be there. Amanda and Dennis Peters. Weekend, what's up? Live from the City Deck, music by Andrew Summers and the...
From the band.
What
He's
band?
From Duke. The band Tuck.
Tuck. Oh, Tuck. Okay, Tuck. I wasn't sure. Okay.
Yep, you got it.
Okay. Tuck. From the band Tuck.
Thanks for checking.
Okay. Yeah. We got a lot of stuff we're going to talk about. We got a lot of people coming up, some fantastic people coming up. Please stay with us. Maino and the Mayor, back after this. Hey, welcome back. Maino and the Mayor here, as I said, on a beautiful Friday morning. Today is Friday, May 3rd, School Lunch Hero Day.
Okay, who's that?
So, okay.
The lady that serves? Okay.
Well, the lady or the guy.
The lunch ladies or whomever, guys?
We had ladies, but I can't remember her name. White hair.
They were the best.
They were the best. They were.
Oh, my God.
Super nice. They're like, it's like, you felt like you were at home because your mom or grandma.
But did they have to wait till they're like 70 to get into that?
Yeah, I mean, seriously,
it's like they were all, you know what I mean?
With a hairy upper lip.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah, absolutely.
There were certain things they had.
We had some great ones, though. Loved them. We had great food. Ed the Diver says, how about Wheel of Misfortune? That's got some possibilities.
I like it.
I like that. Today is also Paranormal Day, Todd.
I'm excited.
I got to tell you a
Todd's
place.
Day.
I don't
Todd
know
Michael's
how
Day.
You can get in anymore, but I walked by it the other day. It's an old warehouse. It's the old cheese warehouse, Jim, right on East River, down in that one corner of town by Attic Books. It's on the way to CVS. When I walked to CVS.
It'd be right across from the old bus station.
Yeah.
Do you remember where Greyhound was on Main?
Yep.
Right there.
So there's a park right there. That's where I take Milton.
I used to be friends with those people. And the people inside hated being there at night. They swear on certain floors things happen. They swear by it. And I thought, it's got new owners now. We got to find out who it is. I think you would love to go in there and do some testing.
I have to tell you, I had an experience right here. About 2 days ago.
Shut up.
Yep. In here?
In the building. Yeah. And there's, you know, I get here early, right? I'm here by 4:45, whatever. And there's days I think I hear you guys walk in and I'll come out and you're not there. So 2 days ago, we have a new salesperson starting. And I had to put together like his door key card and his parking key card, had it all set up for him so that when he came in on Wednesday, well, his parking pass was missing. I put it in a specific location on my desk, kind of in one of those little cubbies that you put your pens and business cards and all that. Had it laying in there, put it in there last week. Wednesday morning, I got here, wanted to get all his stuff ready before we started the show. Key card is gone. The parking card, gone. So I'm losing it. First of all, like,
to check with Jim.
I'm really
to check with me. Save all my quarters. Okay, go ahead.
So I'm going through my bag. I'm going through everything on my desk. I'm going through his desk back there. Where did I put this thing? I know I put it right there. So looked for it all day. Looked for it during the show. I was leaving the studio to find it. Never found it. Amanda shows up. We're working and stuff. And I'm telling her how I lost this thing and I can't find it. So she's looking around. I showed her right where it was on my desk. I said, it was sitting right here. It's a wire mesh container, so you can see right through it. I said, it was sitting right here. She just was looking around, whatever. So I went in there, and I was writing a guest on the whiteboard, and I heard something drop, like on my desk. And in that cubby with my pens, and there sat the card.
Where you had been looking.
Where I'd been looking. And I said, Amanda, please come in here. And she came in and saw it sitting there.
Wow.
I've only had that happen one other time in my life.
I only had one weird thing happen in my life. And I've got a witness to it. A guy was with me. We're shooting a story at the oldest house in the state of Wisconsin. Ugh. It's in Howard.
Where is that?
Howard.
Really?
Yeah.
It's in Howard?
Yeah. Because here's the deal. It started out as a fur trader's cabin.
Sure.
And then just kept getting added on. And then it became the headquarters of the local militia. Because they were coming here and cutting down wood. It became a lumber camp, but they needed protection, you know, because this was so far back. And the guy, the commander, was really ticked off at his troops because they're getting drunk all the time and causing problems. So he completely cut off all their whiskey. Well, one of the guys was so mad, he ambushed him on the porch and shot him and killed him. And the guy's uniform is actually at the Neville, okay?
Wow.
So we were in there, and they're used to it. Also, was a funeral parlor. So we were actually in the funeral parlor, where because it was the only funeral parlor in the area too, and they just lay the people out. And I'm doing the interview with my buddy Les Rentmeester, was a gentleman, phenomenal gentleman. He was a World War II pilot, great whatever, and amazing gentleman. And he was in his 90s at the time. And my photographer and I both heard. And my photographer says, Les, we got somebody's at the door. And Les says, what? I didn't hear anything. And I said, yeah, I heard something too, Les. Okay, this was like February. Ground was covered with snow. He never used that back door. He used a side door. We looked outside. There were no tracks in the snow.
Right.
My photographer and I both said, what was that? I said, I don't know. It's got to be something, right? And he looked out. He says, there's zero tracks. He said, I thought it came from this wall. I said, I did too. Honest to God, true story. I would not make something that, like, I could get the photographer on the phone. He'll say the same thing. There were no tracks in the snow. And we heard outside this funeral parlor,
someone totally knocking on
like
the door.
Honest to God.
That's cool.
Only time I could ever say, what was that?
Yeah.
Today is Chocolate Custard Day. Today is Space Day, which, by the way, was the theme last night in Two Rivers, Manitowoc for the Hardorama.
That's right.
Yes, that's where everybody had the cone heads and everything. Tuba Day.
Ooh, nice.
Who wants to be the kid to play the tuba?
I know.
I mean, God bless them. And with the Badger Band, it's phenomenal.
That's a lot more fun there.
But to cart those things around.
Right. Well, you got to leave them in the practice room.
No, but I mean, out on the field, on the football field.
Yeah. Well, they're kind of fiberglass now. They're not as heavy.
Are they?
Well, the ones that Madison uses, those are probably metal. But no, they're lighter. They're not as heavy as you think. Oh, yeah.
Okay. No. All right. Today is No Pants Day.
Which, Jim, please do not celebrate.
Yeah. Yeah.
Whee!
Wow. I
bet you get real hairy legs. I just got that feeling.
I think it looks like he's wearing a sweater from his neck all the way down to his toes.
Yeah. Whatever.
Is that right? Eric Church is 47. Christopher Cross. Remember Christopher Cross?
Oh, I do.
Sailing. He also did the theme to Arthur.
The best that you can do, right? Arthur's theme.
In New York City.
That was the best movie.
Arthur?
Oh, my God. Dudley Moore. That was awesome. I tell you what, talk about, I didn't watch a lot of movies, but the ones I watched, I know. I know that movie. That was a great, great movie.
Who was the female?
The Leslie. Who was that? That the daughter of?
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Of Wizard of Oz.
You're right.
Yeah.
What's her name? Liza.
Liza Minnelli. Yeah. I always liked her.
Yeah.
I liked her in, you know what movie, I, or not movie, you know what play I saw at the Widener was.
She was here?
No, she wasn't.
Oh.
But I loved the play. The big one she was in about Nazi Germany, right before Nazi Germany. What good is Cabaret?
Oh, yeah, yeah, that would be her.
I love that play. Right. I think awesome. Right. Greg Gumbel from CBS is 78. Frankie Valli is 90. I didn't know Frankie was still with us.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Well, Frankie's been here a couple times.
Has he?
Oh, yeah.
Did you like him?
Yeah. It's just, no, it's a canned show. Yes, he's great. People love him. So.
No, he did Beauty School Dropout in Greece, right?
He was here on Valentine's Day one year.
Really?
Isn't that cool?
Were you worried? Did you not go in case they do the heart cam?
No, I went with my wife, so okay. I was comfortable with it. But
right.
Greg Gumbel, so his brother Brian, is he older or younger?
Brian is older.
Wow.
Yeah.
I thought when I saw 78, I think that's...
I think Brian's older. I haven't seen Brian Gumbel in years.
Brian's is 75.
Oh, Greg is older. I'm sorry. Okay.
But Brian is healthier than Greg in terms of... Because remember Brian, he was on... Gave up salt and all that. He always talked about how healthy he was going
to
be.
He lost too much weight. You know, something. That's why I'm worried. That's why I'm trying to really...
Not lose too much
not
weight.
Not lose too much
right,
weight.
John. Good idea.
At least not too fast, because then your face gets so skinny, skeletoid-like.
Okay, yeah, and that,
I don't want
that's
that.
So important for radio.
I think I'm achieving that goal.
I got to look up the word skeletoid. I'm not sure what that is.
I said I'd let it go. It's Friday.
Yeah. No, I do. I think I'm achieving that goal. It's one thing I've achieved, not losing weight too fast.
Yeah, you're right. That's important, John.
It is.
Take it up.
You got goals, and you need to achieve your goals. I go and speak to kids about that.
Pound a year.
Yeah. Okay, once again, Alec Ingold coming up at the top of the hour. Bellum Sports Medicine, Amanda Dennis Peters, and live music from the City Deck Landing. Mine on the Mayor, and a beautiful Friday. Stay with us.
Search for Maino and the Mayor or WGBW or Oshkosh Air Support and see the entire show unfold right before your eyes. Now, back to Maino and the Mayor, John Maino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Welcome back once again, 97.9 FM, WGBW, 98.3 FM, WISS, and of course, the Civic Media app. Beautiful Friday morning out there. Once again, Alec Ingold, Miami Dolphins fullback, former Bayport Pirate and Wisconsin Badger coming out. We got Bell and Sports Medicine, Charlie Clean with Bell and Sports Medicine coming up. Amanda and Dennis Peters with the Weekend Wood is up. And then we've got our live from the City Deck Landing Studios music coming from Andrew Summers from the band Tuck. Very cool. This segment brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. All I can say is Jim is thinking about turning over his house during the NFL draft. And the guy looked at it yesterday and says, man, you got nice windows and doors, didn't he?
He liked a number of things. But yeah, I mean, and they last, like I told you, and it does look good. I mean, I got to admit, when they're, and they give you different finishings. You can do the wood, the vinyl, you know, of course, mine are all wood. But yeah, it's great. And they, you know, especially upstairs on that third floor, and those are good windows.
He loved your third floor, didn't he?
Yep, he did. He did. He goes,
what do we say, Todd?
Yeah, but I'm not going to do, I don't know if I'm going to do that. You know, I mean, he said, God, we could sleep 10 people up here. I'm like,
that's what I mean. Why would you not?
No, you can't. I don't want that many people in my house. But he really liked the view, looking at the city. He goes, man, this is great. Because, you know, maybe we can, you know, we can definitely rent this house out. And I said, well, how much is it going to be? And he goes, I'm going to get back to you with that because I want to check with some people that.
Comps, basically.
Huh?
Check on comps, what other people are getting. Yeah.
To see, you know.
Right.
Anyway, yes, but he did like that. He did. I told you that earlier. He did comment on the windows and doors. And it, look, I think that was one of the best investments we made in our house. We obviously had to do a new chimney. We had to redo the floors. I mean, there's a ton of stuff we did to that house over the years. But some of it's going to have to be redone. But the windows and doors don't have to be redone. You know,
right.
They're there. And they're great. And, you know, and look, I live in a safe neighborhood, but I still am in the hood.
Oh
and just
God.
The locks that they put on there, too. It's three Todd. Locks. And yeah.
But, I mean, I've lived in
radio.
I'm
going to take him to Flint. I'm going to take you to the north side of Flint, Michigan. Okay? You want to do that? Spend a couple of days there? And then
is that like Astor Park?
Then compare. We'll take somebody that lives there and put them in your house for a week and take you and put them in their neighborhood for a week.
Well, no, that's like that farm thing.
Yes.
That, yeah.
Absolutely. What do you think?
I'll pass.
Okay.
But anyway, yes, I just, you know, and know, someday I'm going to have to sell my house, right? Because there's so many steps in there.
And, I would buy your house today.
Well, no, but you, sure, I don't want to sell it today. But, you know, when in 15, and that's going to be a sad day for me. I just, you know.
Jim, we'll get you one of those lift chairs that go up the staircase.
Like Mrs. Soprano had at the Sopranos.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. Those are always a little creepy, though, aren't they?
Right.
There's something about those that are kind of creepy.
You walk in there and you see it. It's like, I know. Oh, someone's going to die in this house.
When you see somebody coming down.
No. Yeah. The kids would have to, grandkids would have to wait. Where's grandpa?
There's a fire, you know.
Right, Grandma. Get out of the way, Grandma.
No.
That was a Seinfeld episode, remember?
No.
At the birthday party.
Really?
When they had the clown, and the clown was terrible, and he hated George. He was, like, smoking. And there's a fire, and Grandma was in the walker, and somebody yelled fire. Get out of the way, Grandma! And George runs out. That'd be you.
You're right. Anyway, yes, I just. That's
I think
good.
You should.
And the other thing I want to say about, and I said this before, but Verhalen, they do a lot in the community. I mean, they help out at the shelter.
Absolutely.
They help out a lot of charity.
Great local charity.
Yeah, if you're going to buy something, buy it from a company that gives back to the community.
Absolutely.
And a lot of them do. I mean, a lot of them do. I don't, but I for sure, Verhalen does, and I like that.
All right. Kentucky Derby tomorrow. Who are you putting your money on?
Oh, you know what? I'm going to be gone this weekend, so I really...
Oh, you're missing the Derby.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
You never miss a Derby.
Well, I'm missing...
Well, can't you vote offline or something, or online, or I mean, vote...
Bet.
Bet?
Can you bet online? Is that legal?
I think everything's legal with betting these days, isn't it?
Well, even if it wasn't, it wouldn't stop me. I was just
Why don't you run out?
I'm making conversation.
But can't you run out to Oneida right now and place a bet?
Probably.
I'm sure you could.
You want to do that after the show? $20 on something? Long shot? I'll do something that's a long shot, 20
Put 20
to 1.
Down for me. 20, I'll pay you back.
Maybe 20, 25 to 1.
Okay. I'm in.
What? Give me your horse. Do you have it?
No, you pick it for me.
No, I don't want to do that because then you can be, oh, you should depict it. I'm going to pay you back. No, I'm not doing that. You pick the horse. Nuh-uh. No way.
Todd, do you have the lineup? I'll pick a horse.
I'll see if I can find it.
All right. And then with the odds.
Okay.
So,
don't you think I'd be a good track announcer, though?
You would like to be a good track. You would like
and
to be an announcer.
And now the French, they come.
Jeez. Okay, why do we... Let's move on.
It's the only part I would know.
Yeah.
I would be able to see what other ones are. A lot of ways till they're on the far corner. Yes.
That is, you know, that's the most exciting 90 seconds of
You
sports.
Know what I used to so be into? It was almost like the Super Bowl, was the Indy 500. And I couldn't name you five drivers in the Indy 500 anymore.
I don't get car racing.
Oh, really? But the Indy 500 used to be so, because it was Mario Andretti and Al Unser and Bob Unser, Johnny Rutherford, Gordon John Cox, all these big names. I mean, you knew almost every racer. Everybody was like a big name.
When was that? Like
70s.
That guy's old, right?
They're old.
I know, who's the first guy you said, Mario Andretti?
Yeah.
He's been up here a number of times.
Yeah, he was up here. I interviewed him one time for the Red Smith Banquet in Appleton, which used to be a great banquet. I don't know if they still do it. I think they do.
That guy, they named a school after Red Smith, the sports writer, right?
Yeah.
Okay. No, but Mario Andretti was up. You know, Elkhart Lake has that track.
Oh, there you go.
Road America.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, that little track called Road America. Yeah.
Yeah, and he's been to that.
Oh, yeah. Numerous times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm looking over the...
horses and odds?
The horses and their gate. And what is it? Is it gate? What one wins the most? What gate?
No, I would think inside, wouldn't it?
Right, I think it is. I don't know if it's... I don't know. 1, 2, 3. But anyway, so I'd have to look at that again. Mystic Dan, 20 to 1. Third horse in the race.
Read the names. Let me read them like I'm a track announcer.
There's 21.
Well, okay, I'll get through them quick. Thank you. In the first gate, Dornock, 20 to 1. In the second, Sierra Leone, 3 to 1. In the third, Mystic Dan, going off at 20 to 1. Number four, Catching Freedom, 8 to 1. In the fifth spot, Catalytic, 30 to 1. In the sixth spot, Just Steel, 20 to 1. In the seventh card, Honor Marie, 20 to 1. In the eighth spot, Just a Touch, 10 to 1. In number nine, Encino, 20 to 1. Then it's T.O. Password at 30 to 1. Forever Young at 10 to 1. Track Phantom at 20 to 1. That's the one I want. I want Track Phantom.
Okay.
I want Track Phantom.
I'm going with Encino.
West Saratoga at 50 to 1. Ooh, that might be enticing.
Well, you could pay some money. Make some money.
And Limitlessly at 30 to 1. Domestic Product at 30 to 1. Grand Mole the First at 50 to 1. Fierceness at 5 to 2. Stronghold at 20 to 1. Resilience at 20 to 1. Society Man at 50 to 1. And Epic Ride at 30 to 1. So obviously, Fierceness
is good to win.
The favorite,
is
the favorite. Or Sierra Leone. Sierra Leone.
What's that?
3 to 1.
Yeah. That's, yeah.
You don't win a lot then, though.
I'm going to go with either the names and the odds. I want to make a little money on this. With Casino or
I'm going with
Cadillac.
Track Phantom to win place or show.
Yeah, that's pretty conservative bet.
Oh, Kentucky Derby Party at Berkshire Hathaway in Green Bay tomorrow.
No way.
Oh, my God. That sounds cool. Oh, we're going to be in Madison, though.
I know.
Ah, I would go to that. That would be fun.
That would be great. Do you have a runner back to the casino? You got a bookie that's going
to,
you know.
I would need to place this bet.
Okay. I call my brother.
All right. Are they actually going to be betting over there? Because I want part of that sweet, sweet action.
We'll have to call her after the show.
Okay.
Todd, who do you want?
Read this. That's pretty cool. Listen to this one. Who is this? We need to know.
Brian.
Brian?
Yep.
I sold beer and mint juleps. I've never had a mint julep.
That's bourbon and mint, right?
I don't know. I've never had one. I sold beer and mint juleps
at
the Derby.
It's got to be bourbon because it's Kentucky.
Made a ton of cash. Saw the Manning brothers.
Oh, that'd be
and
fun.
Britney Spears.
Wow.
I know Aaron Rodgers is going to be there.
Yeah, he's
actually,
there.
I've got a buddy that's going to be going over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've always wanted to go to the Derby. Yeah. I've always wanted to go to the Derby.
Yeah, and that's...
That's one of my dreams. Mint julep is made with Kentucky bourbon, sweetened with simple syrup, and served chilled with a fresh mint for a classic and refreshing cocktail. I always think of like a grasshopper.
No, there's no ice. No. What do you... No, no.
Isn't a grasshopper minty? Kind of?
Well, yes. It's cream to mint that you're... Okay. It's, yeah, right.
But is it a thick thing or is it more the...
No, this is ice cream in the grasshopper.
Okay.
And there's
I'd love to try a mint julep.
That mint julep...
I would go over there to that party if we weren't going to Madison.
You know, and that does sound refreshing, doesn't it?
It sounds fantastic. I'd love that. I'd want to talk a little bit of the Southern drawl, though.
I had a boss down in Mississippi. His name was Mr. Holliday.
I knew Mr. Holliday. Hey, good gentleman.
Mr. Michaels, why don't you have a seat on the veranda?
Oh, he was a fraternity brother of mine at Ole Miss.
Let me tell you something. Okay. Miss Millie will make you a drink, and then we'll sit and just ponder for a little bit.
Miss Millie was fantastic.
I'm not kidding. That's what it was like.
Wow, I believe it. That was pretty good. I would love to live in the South just for a while.
No, you don't.
Why?
No. Oh, it's.
Oh, I think that's, I would love the South.
They're really good to your face, and then they'll stab you in the back.
Really?
You know what that John Maino did when he was younger? Let me tell you a story.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, oh, that's really good.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
So there's.
What's considered the dirty South? You hear the term the dirty South. What would that be?
I'm not sure, but I think it's like Atlanta. Like some of the bigger cities kind of stuff. I'll look it up, though.
I would love to go to a honky-tonk with a bunch of pickup trucks in the parking lot and old country music playing and stuff. I would love to go to one of those honky-tonks in the South.
Yeah.
Wouldn't you?
Yeah, it'd be fun. Just experience it. Speaking of the South, though, there's something, you know, Cat on a Hot Tin Roof. Have you seen that?
Yeah. Tennessee Ernie Williams.
Yeah.
Paul Newman, Elizabeth Taylor.
I still think
is the most beautiful woman of all time in America.
I think their anniversary or something was, I just read
Big
something
Daddy.
About them. Either it was so many years that they started or something just happened with that. I just saw that. I've seen that play. Anyway, yeah, that's all the South. And they talked just like Todd was doing, which was very funny. Okay. The Dirty South. Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, here's what I want to do.
Okay, but Todd, you can pick your horse.
I'm not going to pick.
Oh, man.
I will bet on the award ceremony tomorrow night.
Don't. So Todd.
So we're going to be in Madison tomorrow for the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association award ceremony. We're up for a couple of awards.
I can't believe that because so whoever told you guys, I can't believe you guys are up for an award. You know, they're not a year. And Bloody's radio guys have been around a long time.
I have to tell
time.
You guys, I'm really proud of you. And I don't want to go off and toot our own horn. But you guys started in what, June?
June 26th. Went through two producers.
So to come out.
We did.
And you're up for a couple of awards and for some great programs that you guys did for the veterans at Duck Creek VFW. That one's up for an award. And your time down at EAA last summer. Nice job. That's not easy, right?
You can
be in radio for a long time and never get put up for an award at that thing.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Well, that's, yeah, thank you.
Or you could just show up like a former mayor and then first year.
Right.
That's going to be fun. So, yeah, we're going down there for dinner. I think we have to be there at like 4.
What time is the Derby? About 4 probably, right?
Yeah.
Is it usually later afternoon?
Maybe they'll have it on in the bar. We can just hang out.
Yeah, right.
There.
And we're that is true. We are meeting in the bar.
Hey, Carrie at Berkshire, can we bet through you guys?
Yeah, right.
I mean, maybe we could. Maybe they've got a thing set up where they're actually betting. And maybe we could go through them.
But we want it to be a real bet, though.
That's what I mean. Oh. But maybe they've got something. We're doing it through Oneida. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
And okay. I could just say, hey, would you put 20? Because they can trust me.
Right.
I'd pay them back if I don't win.
Yeah, right. John, let's. So why don't I?
Carrie, would you do that? Would you place a bet for me?
Should I put 40 down then?
She told you to ask Ben. That was her response.
Oh, okay. That says Ben Indiana.
She also said mint juleps are absolutely gross.
So, oh, really?
That's what she's saying.
Are they serving them?
I don't know. We'll see what she says.
I think there's a party on Broadway.
Are the women wearing the big hats?
Yes. There's a party on Broadway. Remember we talked about that?
Yeah.
So there's something going on with the hats, and I'm sure they're going to be serving those. Somebody's got to be serving those mint juleps.
I really would love to have one. You know what? If we win tomorrow night at the ceremony, we're ordering mint juleps.
I'll drink it. We're not going to win. I mean, I think it's great. We'll be non. I mean, it's going to be fun to get together with some other people.
Wow, Mr. Pessimistic. So anyway, I'm going to go. I want to go this. I want to go $20 on, Carrie, if you're listening, see if you can do this through Ben and Deanna, okay? I want to go $20 on Track Phantom.
Right.
Okay, $20 on Track Phantom, Carrie. Ten. Oh, I like that.
Oh, just now I'm going to bet more than I was going to.
And to the post.
I have to stay away from this stuff. This gets my blood going. This is not good for me.
Okay, listen to me. Listen to me. $10, Carrie. Listen to me. $10 on Grand Mole the First at 50-1.
Yeah. Right.
Okay.
To show. Do that one to show.
Yeah. 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 Win, place, or show. And then $20 on Catching Freedom. Ask Carrie, she'll place those bets for me.
All right.
And I will give them a little something for the effort. All right. We're going to set a quick break. Once again, Alec Ingle, all-pro fullback from Bayport, joining us at the...
Really racy music.
All right. I'm just listening to the music, getting into the rhythm.
I'm going through these verses and...
Love it, love it, love it.
Epic ride, but she's starting out on the 20.
Now, you study everything, though, like, right? It's like,
I used to.
It's good if it's a mutter, if it's a dry track.
The jockey, right?
But that's right. Do you even know any jockeys anymore? I mean, it used to be Angel Cordero.
But you know that guy from Anago? Well,
he's been amazing.
Yeah, but he also
Dukes?
Got,
is it Duke? Luke's?
He'd be getting in a little trouble, too.
Yeah, he did. A lot of those.
Juicing those horses.
That sport has really.
Well, the money.
Oh, but they've, I mean, the horses that have been. Hurting everything over the years now.
Yeah. But I mean, the all time horse, right? Secretariat that just smoked everybody. Yeah.
I will say this. I remember Howard Cosell one time who thought so much for himself, it's mind boggling. And this was actually a pretty good answer, though, that he gave.
Yeah.
Somebody asked him one time at a big interview, said, who is the greatest athlete you've ever seen in your lifetime? You know what he said?
Secretariat. Yeah.
And that brought up a good point. I mean, really, that's a pretty good point.
If you would throw that in, it would be because of all the, it's unbelievable, that horse. So.
But why did the Indy 500 lose its luster? I mean, is it not enough good American drivers anymore? I mean, stock car is just mind-boggling popular, and you get all these great drivers, and it used to be just the opposite. Anybody that wanted to race wanted to be an IndyCar driver. I mean, NASCAR wasn't even on TV back when I was a kid. They would do Wide World of Sports. They would tape it on like a Saturday and play it the following Sunday. It was crazy. And now it's unbelievable.
Isn't the cost of entry like unbelievable for the Indy to get a car and you get...
Well, yeah, it is. By the way, my buddy Knob is doing some preliminary testing because we still haven't gotten the Win Minos money thing going yet. So he threw out a quick question. What is it, Todd?
Where did Terry Nofsinger go to college?
University of Utah. Give me another one. Give me another one.
Who doesn't know that?
That's all I got right now.
But that's how we're going to play that game next week, people. You're going to have a chance to win $1,000 possibly.
You know, you're scaring the bettors off. You just, because you know everything. You've never gotten one wrong since we started talking
about
this.
Well, they got to dig a little bit deeper. Todd, give me another.
But what is there? Wait. I still don't think we've worked this out. So,
well, I got to get a hold of Mike Daniels. No, I left a message from Nicolet Bank.
Right.
It's going to be up to $100 a day. We start out with $10.
No,
if I get it wrong. Or maybe we'll, you know what? Maybe we'll start out at $100 a day.
No, don't do that.
But we could do that.
The guy, the person, guy or girl who calls in, if you win and they don't, they need to put $5.
No, they don't need.
Something.
No. That's illegal, Jim. That's illegal in radio. That's illegal, right, Todd?
Absolutely.
You would lose your license.
Well, then we'll say
if you tried. That would be literally gambling, and you would be taking money from listeners. You would lose your license.
Well, we'll say it was Aaron's idea.
Okay, I'm in.
All right. Or Pete's idea.
Yeah, Pete Schwab.
Pete Schwab came out. He told us
they have trouble. The FCC police are becoming what? What did I do?
7 o'clock. He gets arrested. No
Absolutely.
Show.
Absolutely. Yeah. Oh, nice job spilling your coffee there, Jim.
Sorry about that.
Okay.
Okay. All right. So that Mino's money, are we kicking that off like soon? We've been
I left a message for Mike Daniels. Mike Daniels, if you're listening, please give us a call. You know my number, Mike.
Give
me a call.
Don't even give us a call. Just send us a check.
Check. Yeah, send us a check, Mike. But I want Mike to come in here and actually read off of the actual guys.
All right.
Yeah. That makes sense. Can we do that? Yeah.
Okay. That's going to be fun. So we'll do that next week. And then what was the other thing we were going to do?
He gave me one more here. Mike Lloyd. Southern Missouri. But anyway, somebody could win $1,000.
No, they can't.
Yes, they could. For the very last day, each quarterback is going to be worth $100.
Okay, I talked to that.
And that could be, I want to build it up to $1,000. And if nobody wins at the end, Gary Quazzo, Virginia, at the very end, it would go to charity.
Okay.
Deal?
I like the concept. I just... It's the most exciting game because it would be like us going up against Dr. Chen philosophy, music. I mean, he ran the table in like seconds, like 25 seconds. He cleared out that
he's a fun guy to hang out with.
Yeah, he is.
We hung out with Dr. Chen the other night. He was a fun guy to hang out with.
We were with him Wednesday night. And but when we told him about this, win Mino's money and quarterbacks where they went to college. He was thinking, but I don't think he's going to take you on because I think he likes to win too.
I brought it up to him again. I said, hey, did you get my text about a game show that we could combine on? And he goes, yeah.
I got your text.
You know what I mean? It wasn't, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'm excited about it.
Yeah. I want to talk to you about that. Yeah. It was.
I was like. Yeah,
I think I did get that.
I did get your nine
texts. And I go, why did you leave me on red? And I said, I didn't even know that term until somebody told me what you did.
Did you say that to him?
Yeah. He laughed. I love that term, though, leaving somebody on red. I love that.
Where's that from?
Todd, where did that come from? I mean, that's what the young kids do, right? The kids?
I mean, the kids.
When you message somebody and you can see the little thingy, the little icon or whatever, that they did read it, but they don't respond to you.
I don't think that's
being
my
left
phone.
On red.
Yes.
Oh, you do.
Do I?
Yeah. Yeah, you do.
Everybody has it. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Where it's, I don't like that though, where people can. Okay, can I ask you a question?
Really? I didn't know that.
Can people see if you've heard their voicemail?
I don't think so.
Okay.
That I don't think so.
Okay. Did I tell you a guy called me the other day? I haven't heard from him or seen him since the 5th or 6th grade.
Wow.
And he somehow found me losing Minnesota. Isn't that bizarre?
I can't
wait to talk to him. I mean, that's cool.
Did I tell you off air or did I say it on air about my car, that Super B?
No.
Okay, so this guy sends me a text and didn't know him from listening to your show. I had a Dodge Super B. Remember, that's what I had when I was a kid. And I bought it in 81. You think it's your car? I'm like, I don't know, because can you send me some pictures? I'm like, I don't have pictures of that. He sent me back another text that he bought a Dodge Super B and in 1985 sold it for, what I told you, what my dad paid for my car.
Which was it? How much?
My dad bought my car for $800.
Okay.
Great car. And we got a really good deal on it. And this guy then bought a car in 81, 1985. $70,000.
Wow.
What?
Yep. I told you there weren't a lot of those cars.
It went from $800 to $70,000?
Yeah. So he told me. Yeah, he sent me a text yesterday.
Why? I know they're nice cars. They're hot cars. But
well, I think it's
probably true. Oh, my God. That's the biggest jump I've ever heard.
That was those muscle cars. I can see that happening. There weren't a lot of them around.
But 800 to 70,000?
Well, 800, let's not say that. Let's say it's even $2,000.
Oh, but big deal.
Right. It's 70,000.
I don't care if it's 30,000. Right. Wow.
That's what he said. It went for 70,000.
Unbelievable.
Isn't that? I should have hung on to that.
Did you ask for it back?
I know. I wouldn't be here.
I wish I'd hung on to. Okay. Got rid of my 1967 GTO.
Because, another good car.
Yeah.
That was a cool car back then.
Because it was a phenomenal car. Because I heard that they were no longer going to make high test gas, and these kind of engines wouldn't handle regular gas. And I sold her for about $500. Honest to God, true story. Would I love to have that GTO again? Oh,
I know.
Alec Ingold is in the house. Look at that man. Right. Oh my God, it's like looking into a mirror. When I see him, isn't it though?
Oh,
I mean, just bodies. It's like a mirror. It's like
okay,
a brother.
Okay, this Alec guy is in such good shape. And
all right,
Johnny,
relax, Jim. I don't want to lose too much too fast. You know that.
Right,
back after this.
And raised in the trees of where.